Hi there. This week we looked at solving equations. You have seen useful techniques to attack several types of equations and common mistakes that you should avoid. To get you ready for the homework, let me summarize the most important topics of this week. For any equation that you encounter, remember to take the following steps: simplify, solve, and check. Simplify means reduce your equation to one or several equations that you know how to solve. There is no general recipe that tells you how to do that, but there are some useful techniques. The balance method. Try to simplify the equation by applying the same operation on both sides. Be careful, you may have to separate cases. If the equation has the form of a times c equals b times c, then this reduces to a equals b or c equals 0. Equations of the form a squared equals b squared can be reduced to a equals b or a equals minus b. Some equations can be factorized, that is, written in the form a times b equals 0. In this case, the equation reduces to two simpler equations, a equals 0 or b equals 0. Finally, you can sometimes use substitution. Rewrite the equation in terms of new variable to simplify it. Once the equation has been reduced to several easy equations, solve them and gather the results. Finally, always check the solutions. This way, you can see whether you made mistakes. And even if you didn't, you may have picked up false solutions along the way. This is the general story. But we also looked at specific types of equations. We started considering polynomial equations. Remember that any such equation can be written as p of x equals 0, where p of x is a polynomial function. The most important cases are those where p has degree 1 or 2. The degree 1 equation has the form a times x plus b equals 0, with a non-zero. The solution is simply x equals minus b divided by a. The degree 2 equation has the form a times x squared plus bx plus c equals 0. We have seen three ways to solve it: factorization, completing the square, and the quadratic formula. In the first case, you try to write the equation as a times x minus b times x minus q equals 0. This is not always possible, but if it is, the solutions are simply x equals p or x equals q. In the second case, you try to write the equation as a x minus r squared plus s equals 0. This is always possible, and the equation can then be solved easily. Finally, you can use the quadratic formula. First calculate d, the discriminant. If d is smaller than 0, there are no solutions. If d is larger than 0, there are two solutions, given by the quadratic formula. For d equal to 0, you can still use this formula, but then the solutions coincide. So then there is only one solution. For polynomial equations of higher degree, there is no general method. But there are some techniques that can be useful. If you know a factorization, you can reduce the equation to equations of a lower degree. Sometimes you can guess a solution, x equals a. Then you can write p of x equals x minus a times q of x, where q has degree 1 less than p. Then you try to solve qx is 0. Sometimes you can use a substitution to express the polynomial in terms of a new variable and reduce the degree. But as said, a general method does not exist. However, we can say something about the number of solutions of px equals 0. Suppose p has degree n, then there are at most n solutions. If n happens to be odd, then there is at least one solution. We then considered equations involving rational functions and square roots. The main message is try to get rid of those. In the case of fractions, get rid of the denominator by using multiplication. If you have a root isolated at one side of the equation, then raise to the appropriate power to eliminate it. We have not yet treated equations involving exponential functions, logarithms, and trigonometric functions, but more about that next week. But always keep in mind our three-step plan: simplify, solve, and check.